Thank you, Program Director, Mrs. Mtemi. Honorable Deputy Minister, I want to pronounce your surname correctly for the benefit of everyone. Yeah, Umamo Chikunga, Chairperson of the Board of SAMHSA. And everyone else at that level. I think for the benefit of managing time, I'll say all protocols observed. Ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed an honor and a privilege to be part of this gender-based seminar in the maritime sector as organized by our own South African Maritime Safety Authority, shortly known as SAMHSA. The Department of Transport acknowledges that GBV is a serious violation of human rights and a life, threatening health and protection issue. GBV disproportionately affect women and girls sexually. It is estimated that one in three women will experience sexual or physical violence in their lifetime. The department is committed to continuously support strengthening coordination and programming to protect women and girls from this scourge. Although the number of women in the maritime sector remains low, it has been increasing over the last decades, and therefore a comprehensive study is needed in order to show how many women are actually affected in the maritime industry. And also influence IMO to entrench the culture of protecting women at sea. South Africa must start seriously writing papers and submit these papers to the IMO to start the conversation. And also pursue other member states to ratify such initiatives. Some of the initiatives that the department is planning through the maritime branch is to support the existing mission of seafarers in order for them to collect data from seafarers. The starting point would be the establishment of a memorandum of understanding that will detail the provision of data to allow seafarers access to their families and be able to report any cases and the provision of psychological support in collaboration with the institutions. Gender-based violence, ladies and gentlemen, cannot be attributed to a single factor. It is often an interplay of individual, community, economic, cultural, and religious factors at different levels in the society. It is for these reasons that while government focuses on dealing with the scourge of GBV, it also focuses on the empowerment of women, because there is an evidence indicating that increased empowerment of women reduces their vulnerability to such a scourge. The department is thus championing women empowerment in the maritime sector through initiatives such as Arofcan Network for Women in Transport, Sandwich, and the transport sector BBBEE Charter Council. South African government, as an active member state of the IMO, is committed to promoting gender equality within the maritime industry through the UN 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development and the 17 Sustainable Development Goals, particularly goal number 5. Which says achieve gender equality and empower all women and girls. The focus of the IMO 2019 World Maritime Day theme was empowering women in the maritime community. Gender equality is more than just equal representation. It is strongly tied to women's rights. Hence, there are a number of key strategic posts that are already occupied by women. Our constitution and laws also give women many rights. Most importantly, the Bill of Rights gives all women the right to equality. The Equality Clause says says that no person may be discriminated against on a number of grounds, including things like their sex and gender. November 25th is an international day of the No Violence Against Women. This has become an international campaign that has been adopted by the United Nations and is observed globally. In South Africa, this campaign runs from the 25th of November until the 10th of December, which is the International Human Rights Day. South Africa's President Cyril Ramaphosa has signed 3 gender-based violence bills into legislation, meaning the country has stepped up its protection for women and children, and survivors have a better chance of receiving justice. President Feller stated that government must now continue the task of preventing abuse from occurring in the first place. According to this legislation, it will be compulsory for all sexual offenders to be listed on a national register. The laws will also make accessing protection orders a lot easier, as survivors will be able to apply for this online as opposed to having to head to court to obtain such. Government condemns any form of violence against women and children, so we must therefore work together with police, prosecutors, and courts to ensure that those who hurt and abuse others are arrested and convicted. Gender-based violence does not discriminate any person of any race, age, sexual orientation, religion, or gender can be a victim or perpetrator of GBV. Ladies and gentlemen, men are also encouraged to join the movement to end gender violence. In concluding, men can challenge the normalization of violence to prevent violence against women. We have to challenge the beliefs and behaviors that excuse, justify, or condone violence and inequality. I thank you.